Some might argue that our lives are controlled by technology. Phones, computers, smart cars, even the thermostat in your house. And they're always being upgraded. Some have smart upgrades in their programs, while others see an upgrade in size, storage, features, color, or the number of camera lenses. But do you know the one thing they have in common? The one thing that drives them? Chips. Specifically, semiconductor chips. The semiconductor industry has been a hot topic over the last few years for investors, CEOs, and journalists alike. And everybody has been watching the market shift since the COVID-19 pandemic. In late 2021, Samsung, one of the world's largest semiconductor chip makers, announced plans to set up a $17 billion chip fabrication plant in Taylor, Texas, which will be Samsung's largest ever investment in the United States. The construction of this new fab, short for fabrication plant, is set to bring over 2,000 jobs to the area and increase the United States' domestic production of semiconductor chips. The goal is to manufacture chips based on advanced processing technology that integrates with 5G networks, high-performance computing, and artificial intelligence. Samsung's new plant is located in Taylor, 30 miles from Austin, and will be over 50 million square feet. That's over 1,200 acres of space, which is larger than Samsung's existing plant in Austin. They're breaking ground in 2022 and expect the facility to be operational late 2024. County officials have committed to developing the infrastructure around the new facility, which includes a new four-lane highway to make the new facility as accessible as possible. With a budget of more than $120 million, the southeastern section of this site is currently being developed to include wider roads connecting two major highways, which will connect with the western edge of the facility. Samsung is also getting a ton of local tax breaks to make this deal possible, including a 90% reduction in their property taxes for a decade and an 85% reduction for the following decade. So what makes this new project interesting? And why is Samsung so eager to build another plant when they already have one in Austin? One of the biggest reasons is due to the supply chain issues we've seen since COVID. There is a huge shortage of chips, and tech companies need these chips for all the products they sell, from phones to laptops to washing machines and refrigerators. Almost every form of technology uses these chips in some way, and there is a massive shortage. Samsung, along with Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Co., are two of the largest companies that produce most of the world's chips that they then sell to other companies like Apple and Intel. A lot of companies these days are trying to find ways to improve their supply chain, and governments are eager to invest more to help make it happen. Since January 2021, the chip-making giant has been talking about major US expansion. Samsung had been petitioning state and local governments for subsidies and tax incentives to reduce the increasing costs involved in building a new fabrication plant. Kinam Kim, CEO of Samsung, said that the new fab will help serve the needs of their customers and really contribute to the stability of the global semiconductor supply chain. Before settling on Taylor, Texas, Samsung had reportedly narrowed it down to three states to build this plant. The three states they were most interested in were Arizona, New York, and Texas. And if all three of these plans had failed, they were going to consider just building the fab in South Korea, where the company is headquartered. So why Texas? Samsung stated that their decision was based on a number of factors, like the presence of a robust semiconductor ecosystem, infrastructure, and the big one, willingness of local government to help make it happen. Now, despite several power failures last year in Texas that caused a bit of commotion, Texas actually came out as the number one option for Samsung. These power outages were detrimental to the chip facilities in the area. millions of dollars were lost, and it made the global chip shortage even worse. Power outages are nothing new, and while they're usually short-term, a few happened in the Austin area, which is already home to multiple chip fabs, and it definitely caused some panic and a huge disruption in the supply chain. Chip fabs typically run 24 hours a day, and a facility-wide shutdown due to power failure adds fuel to the fire of an already struggling supply chain where we simply don't have enough chips being produced. Samsung, along with local government officials, struck a deal with Sempra Energy and Encore Electric to make sure that outages during winter storms would not happen again to the degree that it did in 2021. Samsung also met with Canadian EPCOR Utilities to build a water pipeline from Alcoa, which is 25 miles east of Taylor. This agreement means that the plant will make use of a new water source without affecting existing water supply in Taylor. Plus, the fact that Samsung already has a plant in Austin makes it easier for the two facilities to share infrastructure and resources, making Taylor the most logical site for their newest chip fab. The new plant in Taylor definitely adds a win for the Central Texas economy, and all of this certainly looks like the beginning of a bounce back from the global supply chain disruptions. Samsung has joined the likes of Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Co., one of the largest producers of chips, in making significant investments in the US, thanks to some help from policy under the Biden administration and Congress's bipartisan support to bring more chip production to the US. While developments are still underway, we should hope to see a tighter supply chain for semiconductor chips so that companies around the world that use these chips, like Apple, Dell, Texas Instruments, and Intel, can keep up with new demand. For more interesting content on international development projects just like this, be sure to subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time.